Hello viewers, welcome to the episode on departmentalization in hotels. Organizing is the process of structuring human and physical resources in order to accomplish organizational objectives. The organizational structure will help achieve objectives like to maximize revenue through efficient room occupancy, to maximize food and beverage revenue with excellent meals, to earn from minor departments, to give quality service to guests. Departmentalization helps in division of work. We shall discuss the various aspects of departmentalization and organization structure of hotels under five different headings, namely meaning of departmentalization, departments in hotel, functions of departments, organizational charts in hotels, and facilities provided in hotels. Let us discuss about the meaning of departmentalization. An organization structure is a framework which assigns responsibilities and establishes channels of communication to make decisions and set operational accountabilities. It reflects the level of authority in the organization hierarchy. The organization structure is represented through organization chart. Organization chart is a pictorial presentation of the organization structure and the functional relationship of the personnel and the departments in the organization. The organization structure of hotel is based on its size and range of services it offers. Departmentalization refers to horizontal differentiation of tasks or activities into discrete segments. The importance of departmentalization include increases operating skills and efficiency of organization, division of functions and fixation of responsibilities to different executives, increases prestige and skill, evaluation and pinpointing the departments which are not managed properly, scope for expanding the organization to indefinite degree, facilitating budget preparation, effective control of expenditure, attaining specialization, and better coordination among the managerial personnel. Let us discuss about the departments in hotel. A hotel is an organization made up of different departments, all of which have to work in close coordination for the efficient working of the organization. Some departments are more important as far as revenue is concerned. Some do not produce revenue but are very important from the operational point of view. Thus, the departments of the hotels can be classified under three main headings. They are operating and revenue producing, operating and non-revenue producing, and non-operating and revenue producing. Operating and revenue producing departments, that is ORPs. Minor revenue producing departments, laundry. The hotel may have its own laundry or may have a contract with an outside laundry. In any case, laundry of the guest clothing is a facility provided by the hotel and is charged for. Telephone department. Guests are charged for the local or STD calls. In a small hotel, there would be just a small switchboard, probably operated by the receptionist. In large hotels, there exists a separate telephone department where the board is manned by operators working in shifts. Swimming pool. Though hotel guests are not charged for using the pool, their guests can be charged for this facility. Many hotels offer a free swim along with a lunch, charged per head, set up near poolside. Major revenue producing departments. Room departments. These are the departments concerned with the actual sale of rooms. This revenue producing section earns around 60% of the total hotel revenue. The departments under this section are housekeeping and front office. Front office is concerned with actual sale of rooms and hence comes in direct contact with the guests. Housekeeping is concerned with keeping the guest rooms clean and in a position to be sold. Food and beverage department. These are the departments concerned with the production of food and beverage items and their sales. Food and beverage production includes all kitchens, bakery, confectionery, stores, and pantry. All these are behind the scenes and responsible to the total preparation of the food items, right from the storage of raw material to the presentation of the final dish. Food and beverage service. Food and beverage service includes all the service outlets where the food is prepared by the production areas is sold to the guests. These areas can be listed as restaurants, general as well as specialty restaurants. These restaurants have fixed hours of service. Coffee shop. A coffee shop is open 24 hours of the day and serves mainly snacks and beverages. Bar serves alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverages along with snacks. A permit is required to operate it and there is fixed hours of operation. Room service, 24 hours service in most large hotels. Banquets, it is a major revenue producing department among the F&B service departments. Some of the banquet functions are dinners, lunches, wedding receptions, cocktail parties, conferences, club meetings, outdoor caterings, etc. Operating and non-revenue producing departments, that is ONRP. Number 1. Personnel. Deals with recruitment and training of staff, staff induction, promotions, welfare, etc. Number 2. Security. Deals with all unusual events in the hotel. Number 3. Maintenance. They are responsible for total maintenance and upkeep of rooms and public areas, that is air conditioning, lifts, plumbing, electricity, lighting, carpentry, etc. Accounts. Receives a copy of all departmental vouchers and the guest bills. Maintains cash register, city ledger, etc. Sales and marketing. Sales is concerned with getting and maintaining clientele for both rooms and food and beverage. Non-operating and revenue producing departments, that is NORP. They include travel agencies and airline offices, bookshops, chemists, florists, bank, beauty parlor, etc. They either be let out on commission basis or on rental basis. Functions of departments. Number 1. Front office. Sell guest rooms, reservation, register guests and assign guest rooms. Coordinate guest services. Provide in-house and external information to guests. Maintain accurate room statistics and room key inventories. Maintain accurate room status information. Maintain guest accounts and settle their bills. To fulfill these basic responsibilities, the front office is broken into different sections, each with distinct roles. These sections are front desk reception. This section receives and welcomes the guests. The reception registers guests and assigns rooms to them. Information. This section is used for providing various information to in-house guests. Cashier desk. This section is used for checkout process of the guest. The cashier maintains the guest accounts during their stay. Guest relation desk. This section is used for collecting guest feedback and maintenance of guest history. The guest relation executive ensures that all guests, especially the VIPs, are kept comfortable during their stay. Bell desk. This section is used for assistance of guests during check-in and check-out process. Travel desk. This section is used for assistance of guests for arranging vehicles for guest movements and for making train or airplane reservations. Lobby manager. The lobby manager coordinates all guest services. He is the representative of the general manager at all times during the day and night. He or she oversees the bell desk, concierge, transportation, etc. Back office reservation desk. This section is used for taking booking for rooms. Telephone operator. This section is used for attending all phone calls lined up in the hotel. Business center. This section is used for secretarial job of guests. Housekeeping. This department is responsible for the cleanliness, maintenance, and the aesthetic standard of the hotel. Inspects rooms before they are available for sale. Cleans occupied and vacant rooms. Communicate the status of guest room to the front office department. Cleans and presses the property's linens, towels, and guest clothing. And maintains recycled and non-recycled inventory items. Uniformed services. Uniformed service is the collective term for lobby services. The porter service is the main service of uniformed services. Bell attendants. Bell attendants ensure baggage service between the lobby area and guest rooms. Door attendants. They ensure baggage service and traffic control at hotel entrances. Valet parking attendants. They ensure parking services for guests' automobiles. His challenge is to keep a track of the car keys and return them to the rightful owner. Transportation personnel. They ensure transportation services for guests from and to the hotel. Concierge. Concierge provides personalized services and information like making restaurant reservations, arranging for transportation, and getting tickets for theater, sporting, or any other special events, and also offers mails and messaging services. Telephone department. Telephone department answers and distributes calls to the appropriate extensions, whether guest, employee, or management extensions. Places wake-up calls, monitors automated systems, and coordinates emergency communications. Food and beverage department. This department comprises of the kitchen, where the food production takes place, and of various types of outlets where what is produced in the kitchen is served and sold to the guests. Food and beverage outlets might have the forms like restaurant, quick service, table service, specialty restaurants, coffee shops, bars, lounges, clubs, banquets, catering functions, wedding, birthdays, etc. Food and beverage restaurants are bars or lounges. This includes all the restaurants, bars, and lounges that are located throughout the hotel. Food and beverage banquets. This department sets up the rooms where small and large meetings and events, including weddings and receptions, are held. They take place in the various conference rooms and ballroom of the hotel. They also provide the service of food and drink to the guests at these events. The banquet department coordinates the details of an event as it is happening, executing the requests the guests have made prior to their arrival and responding to any unexpected needs of each guest. Food and beverage, culinary. This department includes all the kitchens of the hotel. Typically, a hotel will have a main kitchen, a satellite fine dining restaurant kitchen, a banquet kitchen, a cold kitchen, a pastry kitchen, and sometimes a pool kitchen. These various kitchens order, receive, store, and prepare all the meals in the hotel. They also prepare the beautiful buffets and the guest room food facilities. Food and beverage room service, also known as in-room dining, this department provides meal and beverage service to the guest in his or her room. The meal is always beautifully presented as if the guests were at a table in one of restaurants. This department operates 24 hours of the day. Food and beverage stewarding. This department stores, cleans and distributes all the equipment, that is glassware, silverware, chinaware, etc., that is needed in food and beverage service for the guests. This stewarding department supports the entire food and beverage operation, providing important equipment supply and cleaning services to the kitchen and to every food and beverage outlet. Food and beverage storeroom. This is the storeroom where all fresh produce, meat, dairy and preserved foods as well as beverages are stored at the correct temperatures and in an orderly way until they are needed for preparation in the kitchens. Sales and marketing division. The marketing department creates the groundwork to get customers to want to select the property for their stay and converts that decision into a sale by actually booking a room. A typical sales and marketing division is composed of four different sections, namely sales, convention services, advertising, and public relations. The sections coming under sales and marketing are public relations. The public relations department ensures that the image of the hotel and the company in the local community is always maintained at a very highest level. They also make press releases whenever there is something important to announce and maintain excellent media relations. Sales and marketing, catering sales. The catering sales department sells, plans and coordinates all social and local corporate catering events such as wedding, retirement parties, society events, local functions and meetings. Each catering sales manager is also responsible for individual booking goals and for achieving departmental budget requirements. Sales and marketing conference sales. This department sells the space that guests need to hold their meetings and social events in hotels. Finance and accounts. The accounting division monitors the financial activities of the property. Some of the activities that are undertaken in the accounting division are: pays outstanding invoices, distributes unpaid statements, collects amounts owed, processes payroll, accumulates operating data, compiles financial reports, makes bank deposits, secures cash loans, and performs other control and processing functions. Engineering and maintenance. This very department maintains the property's structure and grounds as well as electrical and mechanical equipment. Some hotels might have this very division under different names, such as maintenance division, property operation and maintenance department. Security. Security division personnel are usually screened from in-house personnel. Security officers are retired police officers across certain physical skills and prior experience. Some of the functions of the security division are: patrols the property, monitors supervision equipment, ensures safety and security of guests, visitors and employees. Human resources. The department is responsible for the hiring, maintenance and exit of staff. The functions of human resource department are: recruitment of qualified people, orientation program, training, compensation and benefit. It is an important function to ensure that salary and wages are kept competitive. Good performers are rewarded through good performance appraisal policy. Ensures employees' safety and working conditions. exit formalities to ensure that all the dues to an existing employee are honored as per the labor laws. Other divisions. Some other divisions that might exist in a hotel are retail outlets, that is, shops rented to outsiders or managed by the hotel, recreation facilities, example, fitness center, tennis courts, and cinema saloons, conference centers, and casinos. Organizational charts in hotels. Organizational structure of large hotel. Large hotel operations require more people to operate it. People working in hotel are specialized in different areas of operations like front office, food and beverage, etc. There is elaborate organization structure because of the specialization in large hotels. According to the policies of the hotel, organization chart can be modified. Organization structure of small hotel. In smaller hotels, there are fewer people with multiple skills. According to the policies of the hotel organization chart can be modified. The day-to-day operations of a hotel are the key factors determining the success or failure of its service. Regardless of the size of a hotel, the organizational structure will be basically the same. It is usually divided into several distinct departments, each responsible for a particular area of work. The larger the hotel is and the more facilities it offered, the more specialized the departments become. For example, the front office and housekeeping department are under the control of the director of rooms. Facilities provided in hotels. Today, hotels provide varied types of facilities for the comfortable stay and memorable experience. These additional facilities are not only available for the hotel guests, but also for general public, and hotels often generate additional income from offering the use of other facilities. Some of the basic facilities available in hotel complexes are parking, valet services, 24 hours reception, money changing facility, room service, left luggage facility, mail service, travel desk, shopping arcade, multi cuisine restaurant, coffee shop, bar, business center, laundry, library, swimming pool, fitness center, spa, child care, conference facilities, bookshop, room facilities, bathroom with hot and cold running water available 24 hours, drinking water with minimum 1 glass tumbler per guest, sufficient lighting, 1 per bed, shelves or dryer space, wardrobe with minimum 4 clothes hanger per bedding, a mirror at least half length, that is 3 feet, a waste paper basket, a bedside table and drawer, telephone, music, air conditioning, mini bar or refrigerator, safe keeping or in-room safe, television with cable. To conclude, in this episode, under departmentalization of hotels, we have learned how organizing is done in hotels, the various types of departmentalization in hotels. We also learned the functions carried by these departments, facilities provided to customers by hotels, etc. We will be learning more about this industry in the coming episodes. Thank you.